This is where the cutout took place. They're going to tear down this retaining wall. We got the bees out just in time. The backhoe is going to be here tomorrow. We're doing a cutout here. These bees are entrenched behind the retaining wall made out of railroad ties. You wouldn't think they care about the creosote. I don't know. Evidently, they're doing fine.
Incidentally, they've chosen a sturdy place to live.
Yeah, that's
it's
a fortress.
Taking some effort to get them out.
The bee fortress. There brood in it?
Nope.
There's dirt in it?
Whole mess of dirt and pollen. Now, let me see. Now, look how little they are.
Are they small shell?
Yeah. Look at that.
Yeah, this looks I'm gonna go get the ruler out of my car and let's measure it. This is a cutout piece of comb, pollen in this one, and it measures right about 4.9 millimeters cell size, so they're definitely small cell.
It's kind of neat.
They look like pollen hoarders, lots of pollen
in there. They are. There's a lot coming in still. I mean, even the entire time I've been doing this, I've been seeing yellow going back and forth, so.
Is that your bee smoker there?
No, no, this is the Rockwell Sonicrafter X2, but it has a dual function. Uh-oh. Hold on. First it unplugs itself. There we go. So first, there we go. First what it does is it'll actually cut through most anything, but at the same time, the dual purpose comes in. The bees and calms them while you're riling them up at the same time.
Do they like creosote smoke?
I don't know. I don't think so. I don't.
Good way to catch bees.
Yeah.
We finally found the brood chamber. It's dusty, but there it is. See some brood in between that comb there.
Oh, yeah. Anywhere that they've been able to find a space, they've made comb, but here's the interesting thing is they have anything they couldn't move out, they've propolized. And so they've propolized this whole chunk of rocks and dirt, and they've stuck that all together with propolis, like that one there. That is interesting.
How much propolis do you see on the ties?
Not a lot, which is odd. They've waxed it quite a bit, but I don't see a whole lot of propolis on the.
You'd think that the creosote on the ties, they'd want to cover that up, but apparently it doesn't bother them much.
Which is crazy, because I thought it would. Yeah, look at this propolis here, big chunks all through there. I mean, this is. That's wood there, but they've propolized all of that.
Huh. That keeps it from caving in, I guess.
Yeah.
This will be chapter, I don't know, 4 or 5 in my book. Beekeeping for the ambitious.
Or stupid.
Or stupid, right? Or bored and...
There you go.
When do beekeepers use sludge hammers?
Only when they want to get stuff done. Just to keep them from being dead.
Oh, okay. You want them in there then?
Yeah, we'll get them in there. Oh, here, let me. I opened the vent just to get them some air.
Oh.
There we go. There's the suction. That's what's nice about this vacuum.
Uh-huh.
You got a, you find it's too much suction, you can open up this little door here.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
And you can lessen or
bypasses the
increase or decrease.
Yeah.
If you try and do it straight into a bee vac, you make bee soup.
Uh-huh, yeah, right.
Which is bad.
We don't want to do that.
So we do it into a hive body. So that's just the bottom portion, but this part got a hive body, and then there's a screen up here. So when you get done, basically all you do, when I get home, I'm going to take this off, put a box on top of it with the comb that we've cut out, and they'll move up into that, and then you just take the rest off, and they'll move into that one.
Nice. Homemade, do-it-yourself bee vac.
Yeah. So I just got to find a way to get honey out of there. An effective way to get honey.
That's what you need your wet vac for.
There you go. Wow. Did you get a tight shot of here? Just the...
That is neat. A lot of brood comb there. Maybe we'll find the queen.
Fingers crossed.
There's who we have in there. There's quite a few bugs in there. Yay! So we're going to put a frame of brood in, hopefully have them sink all down to it. And we'll go from there.
You split that middle bar, you just take one of them out and wrap it around the frame. You're able to actually get an entire comb in there. I don't have to cut that down. I don't have to do anything to that. And it goes right into the comb, and they can just build straight from there.
Two boxes. That's a lot of bees for a cutout.
Yeah.
Got most of them. They're nazinothing on the front of the box. We didn't see the queen, but there's a good chance he's in there.
That was, and there's still some comb back in there. I can't reach.
We got most of it out there.